Hey everyone, Digital David here. Today we're going to be unboxing and reviewing the LMTIC 3-pack of LED under cabinet lights. They did send me this product review, but any opinion expressed in this video is strictly my own. That being said, if you're interested in this product, the link to it will be in my video description below. So please go ahead, check it out, and do your shopping from there. Here's how it comes packaged in a really nice retail box from Amazon. Now let's go ahead, guys, and open it up. Here are all the package contents. First up, we have a really nice user guide right here with all the technical details for you. We have a remote control with on and off. You can see we can adjust the timer settings right here, as well as the brightness. So this is a nice remote control with full functionality. They do not include the AAA batteries. You're gonna need two AAA batteries to use the remote control. Next up, we have three USB to micro USB charging cables, and then three identical 10 LED 120 lumen lights with that built-in rechargeable battery. And they have the magnetic strip on the back with 3M adhesive, so you can stick this under a cabinet or in your closet, wherever you want on a wall, and then this will just magnetically attach to it. Back to the light too, we can see the nice sensor on the front with their branding. On this side, we got a quality control sticker and your micro USB charging port for the built-in battery. That can last anywhere between 6 and 8 hours, and it takes a couple hours to charge. Then on this side, you can see we have a security screw right there, and then we have your on, off, and auto buttons right there. So guys, now let's go ahead, let's power them on and test them out. I'm back now with all three of the lights powered on and all of my studio lights off. The camera's probably not going to show you how bright they really are, but they are bright lights. They'd be perfect for under your cabinets, in a closet, to be a night light, that sort of thing. They got three settings, right? So they got the power off, power on, and auto mode. So if you have it in auto mode, then you can use the remote control. And what's cool is I can control all three lights at the same time. We can take it to 50% brightness right there, go back up to 100%. Or we can just manually adjust the brightness ourselves all the way down to the lowest setting. And then we can go all the way back up to 100. And then we got the timer settings as well for the lights to go off and back on. So you can see as soon as I push the setting, then they flicker and it shows that they've been set to whatever setting you have them on. So again, off, on, in that auto mode. I'm definitely impressed. Maybe you can see some of the detail of me in the camera with these lights so close. Here you go, guys. You can see I installed one in my closet and it looks great and works great. I'm really happy with everything about this. Installation is as simple as peel and stick. And now you can see how bright my closet is. Let me go ahead, grab the remote. We'll turn it off for you to see how much darker it is. So with the light, look at how great that looks. Not bad right now because it's light outside in my room, so it's getting light from the window. But at night or early in the morning, you definitely want to have a light. So you could do it in your closet or, like we said, in the kitchen, under a cabinet, a bookshelf. You name it, you can get really creative with these lights. So you can see I installed it in my closet, no problems at all. Just want to point out for installation, make sure the surface that you're sticking this to is clean, free of debris, dirt, that sort of thing. Also make sure it's not wet still. If you did clean that spot, give it some time to dry. You're not going to want to try to peel this back off your wall and stick it somewhere else. Chances are it's going to lose its adhesiveness. You don't want the light to fall. Also, this can be really strong, so it could damage your drywall, and you don't want to have to retouch up paint everywhere. Couple more findings after using it for a little while too. It's got the on, off, and auto mode. So you have to have it in auto mode to be able to use your remote control. And then off and on are just simple modes. Off is off, on has the light on the whole time. Usually when you see this sensor, there's like a motion element or a photo eye element where it can gauge the brightness and then turn the light on or off automatically. But that does not appear to be the case after investigating this online on the Amazon description. So this is a great light if you just want to be able to remotely turn something on and off, like under your cabinets, in a closet, that sort of thing. But if you're looking for that auto feature, I'd love to see that be incorporated right here with this sensor, to be able to have this come on and off automatically. So let me know what you guys think in the comment section below on this light. If you're interested in it, the link to it is in my video description below. Please go ahead, check it out, and do your shopping from there. Hit that like button for us, subscribe to our channel. We have new content coming out daily, and we don't want you guys to miss any of it. So be sure to turn notifications on. Also, follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. Message us on WeChat. Check out our website and join our free newsletter. Guys, we have new content coming out daily. So we can't wait to see you in our next video. Thanks.